ओके बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान अस्सलाम वालेकुम। इन द प्रीवियस लेक्चर वी डिस्कस अबाउट द फोरकास्टिंग टेक्निक। फर्स्ट फोरकास्टिंग अप्रोच वन ऑफ द मोस्ट इम्पॉर्टेंट अप्रोच दैट वाइडली बी यूज टू मेक अ डिसीजन। द बेसिक आइडिया फॉर दिस अप्रोच इज प्रिडिक्टेड फॉर द फ्यूचर, मेक अ प्रेडिक्शन फॉर द फ्यूचर। Obviously, this prediction requires if you have the data will be used to make the prediction for the future. If you do not have the data, something else will be required. So, the most common example for the prediction is the as simple as we can say that as simple as we can say what about the weather? What do you think based on the forecast? Today or tomorrow will be the rain or not? Or tomorrow will be the cold? Today or tomorrow will means tomorrow will be the cold or not. Obviously, for example, based on the forecast, we can say it will no, it won't be hot. It will be cold comparatively. As complex as we can say, the government make a budget. Make the budget, and moreover, as you can see, yesterday we had the news. The kingdom they want to stabilize the price of the oil. For the, all of the future, it means they are what they are making the prediction for the future, as simple as this one. Now, we were discussing two approaches were there for the forecasting, the qualitative and the quantitative. If we do not have the data, obviously, if you don't have the data, then how can you make the forecast? It is not easy. Something else to be done. You cannot use mathematical model for the qualitative. The situation is when the situation is vague, when the situation is not clear, when the product you want to forecasting is not stabilized, when the product is new, you don't have the data, then we will go for the qualitative. Then what about the quantitative approach? If you have the past data is available, then you can use the mathematical approach, mathematical equation, mathematical computation method can be used. Obviously, for all those cases in which you want to make the forecast, you have the data. Have the data. Have the data means the system, the product is stable. You know the technology. People they are using the technology. Moreover, mathematical model they are available. We can apply the mathematical model. This is what we have discussed in the previous. Now today we will discuss about other important aspect for these one by one as overview of the qualitative method are the noted that what we are dealing, we are doing of the qualitative method. Qualitative method means you do not have the past data is available. You don't have data is not available. Past history is not there. So then the situation is something confusing or something ambiguous. Moreover, the product is something new technology, new product were there. Because of the new product, you don't have the data. Then all of the forecasting most likely on the intuition of the decision maker. Skills or intuition means imagination, his skills, his experience. Then the first category for the qualitative are jury of executive opinion. Jury of executive opinion means pool's opinion of high level executive, sometime augmented by the certain model. Working in the organization, especially for the big organization, they have high executive were there. Most commonly, we can say senior executive, vice president, or vice president, or top management. These top management people, obviously, they have the very high experience were there, very huge experience to working in that to working in that domain. Then we get that using of these opinion means high level executive they and because of their vast experience in the relevant field, use them to make a decision. Moreover, we have some available statistical model. Suppose want to make the decision about the for example, what should be right now, for example, integrated telecom or Zoom. They have the fiber optic comparatively they are new as compared to the SSE and mobile. They were new. What they have the product of the fiber optic, and it is not clear that either they will be in the profit or not will be in the profit. So for those cases, they will apply the jury of executive, top executive. They were in the field of telecom. They know what are the demand, what the future, what should be the future demand, and what should be the pricing. So this is the example for the jury of executive opinion. Second method, Delphi method. Delphi method is panel of experts. Some panel of experts were there and queried iteratively. Iterative means repeatedly means raise one question, have one query, answer the query, then they find another question, answer that query, solve that query, then it will create another question. This process will continue unless and until they find some of the forecasting. This process will continue. Obviously, when you make a forecast, some question have been arises. You answer that question, it will create new question. So this is normally known as a query iteratively. So there are the panel of experts were there in that domain, in that particular domain, and they make the forecast. Third category about is Salesforce composite. Salesforce composite means estimate from the individual salesperson are viewed from the reasonableness, then aggregate. Take simple example for the journey. When you, for example, I want to purchase the smartphone. Obviously, I need to make the interaction with the salesperson. Say, I will ask salesperson, okay, about the particular brand, particular configuration, particular resolution of the smartphone, particular color, particular. For example, I can say, I must have the. I have my smartphone should have the capacity, storage of, for example, storage of 64 GB, 128 GB. What should be the color? I sometime ask some of the question about the do you have this color, particular color, or do you have this feature? What I need to mention as that these salesperson, because they have the direct interaction with the customer, they know much more about what the customer like, what the customer does not like. Customer like means customer will purchase the selected product, will intend to purchase. Obviously, it is not possible whatever I like in term of color, in term of capacity, in term of range, in term of different features. It is not possible that this product should be available. At least customer knows that the what the at least the salesperson knows, sorry, salesperson knows what the customer like, what the customer demanded. So this, it means their feedback can also be very important and can be used for the forecasting. It means the management, they will collect and aggregate all of the feedback from the salesperson. Because they have the direct interaction with the customer, they know much more about the customer preferences. Fourth category is about the consumer market survey. Sometimes the consumer market survey means, as you are familiar, that before launching, especially for the mobile, before launching the product, what they do? The what they pre or they sometimes they have the customer survey, customer market survey. Sometimes they have the pre-order. Pre-order means, for example, the different mobile company outlet or somewhere there. They if you make the pre-order, then you will have some advantages. What does it mean pre-order? Actually, they want to check about the customer's willingness, customer like or does not like. What then based on this feedback, the brand the brand obviously they can make the forecasting either new product launches what they want to launch they will the customer will like will not like or this is one of the example or might be possible sometimes they ask the customers and of or another reason they can say is something new obviously what for example I want to put a new smartphone or laptop. Might be possible. I also see the reviews about the customer who already purchased. Means review. I will people if they have a very positive reviews. I can say, oh, maybe I may also like this one. So it means although we do not have the much more data, but at least the other customer survey have the weightage. Now let's talk about another important other over. Over the quantitative approach. Where do we use the quantitative approach? In which product is mature, stable. People know technologies, technology people know, people they are familiar technology. Moreover, we have the past history, their sale or something about people already know, people past history were there, and at least we can apply some mathematical model on them. If history is there, history is there, then number are there, then we can play with the number, known as the, this most common known as the quantitative approach. Let's see what are the quantitative approach. A series, in order to understand the concept for the quantitative approach, first we need to know about the, what is the time series. Time series for quantitative approach with some interval of time, equal interval of time, then we have some outcomes were there. Outcome, but let's see what. In order to start, first we need to what is the time series. Then we apply the time series. Is an uninterrupted set of data, observation, set of feedback, set of numbers, set of data, the uninterrupted means there is no interruption between them. That has been ordered equally. There must be ordered, must be ordered means in term of sequence, ascending in term of sequence, that in equal time, in space over time, unit of time, in equal time. Practical example can be defined for the time series as, suppose I want to make the forecast for the month forecast, then using the month forecast for the whole year. So it means I must have the data for January, February, March, April, May, June, July, August in term of uninterrupted. It's not that I am missing June, I am missing February. Uninterrupted data is available. Then they must be ordered, properly ordered. First January, then February, then March, then April, then May, then June, then July. Then this type of the phenomena known as a time series. That is available, uninterrupted, without an interruption, must be in the sequence, properly ordered, and equal interval of time. I just example for the month. These same concept can be also applied for the weekly. The same concept for the weekly. So we will discuss more detail in the next slides. Then what are different categories for the in the quantitative, we have the associative also. What are the association or associative? Or casual associative forecast is based on the identification of variable factor that can predict value of the variable in the question. In the association, we need to find the association between, first we will identify what are the variables. We will identify, find out what are the variable factor parameter that can predict the value of the variable in the question. Identify the what are the factor variables were there. Once we identified, then with applying some of the mathematical approaches were there, then we can apply mathematical approaches and find the association. We will see what are the association models. For example, here association linear regression. In the linear regression, here suppose in the x axis, y axis. In the linear regression, so y equal to ax plus b. Later on we will discuss, just for your knowledge. So if some are dependent variable, some are independent variable. These are x is independent variable, this is a dependent variable. Then most commonly x represents something time, y represents something output. So then we want to find out the association or intercept and the what are the association between them. Then we have the time series model. Even for that, for the time series, we have different models over there. Number one is the name approach. Number two is, what is the name approach? Name approach S is the simplest one. Assume the demand in the next period is the same as demand in the most recent period. Suppose I want to apply the name approach for example, for the coronavirus. Today, what will be the total new affected patient and what are the recoverables? Might be possible the recoverables are more, the difference between the 10, 15, 20, etc. For example, I am not pretty sure what is the total numbers. Just your knowledge, for example, just knowledge that the yesterday, what was the, we have the data that there were recoveries of the 310 and they are more effective are 315. or 315, for example. So what is this is our most recent data they are available for the yesterday. If I want to make the forecast today or tomorrow, it means for most recent data will be used to forecast for the next, for the future. Most, what is it? For example, obviously at the evening we will receive the data for today. For what do you think? What might be the number of what might be the new numbers for the corona? If you will apply the forecasting is, if I will using the there are number of methods over there. If I am using the method for the naive approach, then what I will do that demand in the next period or the demand means or what are the number of effective coronas for the next period is the same as the most recent one. What the most recent one? Yesterday was the most recent. For yesterday was the most recent. So this type of following this approach known as the naive approach. Although it does not make sense because what is the number of effective yesterday? How likely they will be today? There must be some variation, but this is the most simplest one. Second one is about the moving average approach. In the moving average approach, we will, for example, we can make the average of last three, last two, last four for the future. We will discuss these techniques later on. Then we have then we also have the weight moving average method. Some weightage will be given. Then the exponential smoothing technique. In the exponential smoothing technique, exponential factor will be used. We will then there is a trend projection approach. Trend projection means sometimes what we found that trends were there increasing or decreasing. What is trend? In the time these are represented either in, for example, increasing or another trend is, for example, is decreasing. These increasing or decreasing, they represent the trends were there. Our data will, for example, more like represent this one. This one. These trend are increasing. And for example, if these trend represent the decreasing as, for example, this one. What is represent? Decreasing trend. And moreover, also another time series as a stationary in which we have the average is equal to zero. This is the average station we will discuss later on. Then we have the association model. Then the association model. In this way, we will make use of the linear regression, least square method, linear regression method. We will see each of these different techniques one by one later. Right now, first we need to know about what is the time series. As we saw in the previous, we use the word time series. This is the for these approaches, for these four approaches, okay, it depends on the time series. First, we need to know exactly what the time series that will be used in the forecasting. A time series is sequence equally spent. It is sequence evenly spaced event. Events they are equal. For example, here it is simple. Take the example of this one, in which we have in term time. For example, in these are time 2010, 2011, 2012, 2013, 2014, etc. And these are the corresponding sale for these are the corresponding sale. So in other words, for 2011, we had a sale of 78.7 million, for example. Okay. Then in the next year, 2012, we had a 63.5 million. Then 2013, 2014, 2015, etc. What we normally find, these are the sequence of equally spaced. It equally spaced means 11, 12, 13, 14. They are equally spaced. It is not you have 11, then you have 13. You don't have the data for this one. This is not just equally spaced. Or moreover, for example, right now we are dealing with the yearly data. This is the yearly data. It is not that we will something include about the monthly. If you are using the monthly, then for all of the time series, use the monthly data. If you are using the yearly, all of the time series data, you will choose in the yearly. The same you apply for the daily or weekly, etc. Then time series forecast predict the future based solely on the past value of the variable and other variable argument. In order to make the forecast, sometime we may have the number of factors over there. Moreover, if you are using the time series, then only factor we will consider for the forecast for the future, only for the time, past data there available. If there are another variable that can somehow affect the forecast, we will ignore them. past value only be used of the variable. So for example, if I want to make a forecast for 2016 here, so only the past value, for this past value will be used. This past value, then set of evenly spaced numerical, these are the set of evenly spaced numerical 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. They are the numerical corresponding demand or sale, they are given as evenly spaced. Then operate by observing response variable, the regular interval time. These are the observer responses or outcome for these regular interval of time. Then forecast based on only past value. These forecasts, they only depend for this category of time, only past value. Only past. If we have another parameter, we will ignore them. Assume that the factor influencing the past and the present will be continuously influenced. So our assumption is, what are the factors they were influencing forecasting in the past? They will continue to influence in the future. So this is the basic idea, past, present, future. With the passage of time, obviously this is the simplest one. For with the passage of time, sometime what the factor they were influencing the past, they were changed during the present or the future. But right now we are dealing with the simplest one. In the time series, in time, it is assumed that the whatever the factor influence in the past, they are same as the present and the future. Now let's talk about what are the component of time series. Right now we discuss about the time series. Okay, at the graph, as simple, the graph is represented by S. This is the time series. Time and what are the responses? Demand, sale, these are the time, and y-axis, demand, sale, whatever the y, either it can be sale, it can be demand, etc. So our time series has the four important components. First one is about the trends. Trends means these trend is generally gradual upward or downward movement of the data pattern. So it means these trend can be represented by the increasing or decreasing. For this particular over the interval of time, this will be, if you draw the graph, is increasing or decreasing pattern. So obviously we require some imaginary line we can draw. These are data over there. Some imaginary line we can draw the increasing or decreasing. Second one is about the season. The important component of our time is the season. For the as I mentioned, trend is season is a pattern of demand fluctuate over above and over for the trend line that represents regular interval. Here, for example, here I am talking about this something increasing. For example, these are the trend. What they mean about the season, these are the pattern of demand, they will fluctuation above and below trend line. A trend line, above and below, they will repeat it. Just for them, they repeat them. These are the repetition were there above and below the trend, above that regular interval of time. Even let me, for example, what is the practical example I can show you that that will be applied for the season is, suppose about the calendar, about the climate change. For example, right now we are dealing with the winter, and if you want to purchase the garment, more probably I will purchase the garment for the jacket, for the something that will be help us to bear for the winter. I will not purchase the garment for the summer. We do not use jacket. So in other words, we can say seasonally means the trend will above and below for the regular interval, and most likely it will be applied for the or follow for the calendar, for the climate changes, etc. Or moreover, we can say it can be tied to the yearly cycle. Means if I want to make the sale for the winter cloth, then for the winter cloth, for example, for the month of January, February. So it means I cannot compare the sale for the winter cloth for the month of June and July. June and July, we have the summer, hot. So I need to make the similar comparison for the next year or the previous year. So these are the, because it more or less we can say climate change or calendar or yearly cycle or yearly. Then let's talk about the second category about the, yes, cycle or pattern in the annual data that occur every several year. Some of the data, okay, these are the pattern. Normally they will apply on the data, but they will occur after they occur every several year. What does it mean? Economic growth, economic condition. Let's take simple example as the, we can say, oil prices. The price of the oil, it is representing, for example, it is representing means sometime, for example, as we found at 2013, the price of the oil, they were very high, around $130 per barrel. Right now it is trading around $65 per barrel. So these are sometimes there are the fluctuations we are encounter or studying in perspective of the several year. After some time, obviously this price will be high, this price will be low. So in this component of the time series, if you are dealing with the cycles, okay, their pattern we want to study in the annual data, and they will be occur for the every several years. Another component is a random variation. Random is something you cannot predict. Something, for example, since last year we were dealing with the coronavirus. Coronavirus, we have the impact on the economy, and the price has been, for example, as you saw last year, the price of the oil was dropped because there is no consumption of the oil all over the world. So this is something you cannot predict. Can anybody imagine before January 2020 that there is a large economic breakdown because of the corona? Nobody can assume that. No. So it means something that the unusual situation. Variation is, these are the blips in the data that cause of the chance or unusual situation and follow no discriminable pattern. This type of the random pattern variation were there. You cannot imagine, you cannot anytime, anywhere can occur. So, but we can incorporate in time series as a random variation. These concepts will be clear when we were dealing more clear. Yes. Now let's talk about the stationary forecasting model. What is a stationary model? In this is the type of stationary is something constant. X-axis in the time, Y-axis in the sale, for example. Then these are the stationary means. If I change the color means, suppose these represent the up and for the sale dots. That means first right. For example, these points represent the sale for different time, 2010, 2011, 2013, 2014, 2015, 16, etc. So these dot represent. So if these dot represent the original, these are the observed value, these are the observed value. Then if you want to make the estimation, then we can compute it the mean, or these represent the stationary means it is not, if you want to make the comparison, they are not increasing or decreasing. They are not increasing or decreasing, but they are stationary. But they are stationary. Fluctuation with this one. These are, in the stationary model, we don't have trend. So in a stationary model, the mean value of the time series assumed to be constant. If we compute the mean here for the stationary, then the mean value is constant. The mean value is constant. So if a time series does not have the trend, so it means for the First, with the timeline along with the data, if we will draw a graph, for example, this graph represents something trend, increasing. This graph shows the trend with the decreasing, or season, or the cyclic component. As we see in the previous slide, we talk about the trend, season, cycle, or random components were there. If we do not have any of these one, then we can say it will be a stationary model. Stationary time follows the stationary time series model. The general form of such model is we follow the equation for example, as y t is equal to beta plus error epsilon t at time t. What is y? Let's see. Y is the value of the time series at it's a value of the times at time period t. At t1, for example, y1, y2, y3, y4, y5, these represent in general we can say yt. It means these are the observed value at time t, at for example, time t1, t2, t3, or 2010, 2011, 2012, etc. Second is the beta naught. What is beta naught? Means represent the unchanged mean value of time series. What is the mean value? These are the mean value. Unchanged mean value of the time series. They are the mean value. If you compute the mean, okay, these will be unchanged. Then of time, some mean. How can we compute the mean? Compute mean means make the summation of all of the observed value divided by total number of the observation. Then we have epsilon. Epsilon is a random error term in the time. Random error means these are the random error time. Some error were there. As you can see, for example, here, let me change the color so it will, you have more. Yes. For example, here, these are randomness. Although these are stationary, but a little bit, for example, these are the, some error over there. These are random error over there. A little bit random error represented by T. So let's, yes. Here is the value of the epsilon. That is, what are the error are assumed to be independent. These error represent the error at time t, they are assumed to be independent. They does not depend on any other factor. The value of epsilon t are assumed to be at the mean zero. Mean zero means if you will compute it, the mean or average for all of the errors, these are the error over there. For example, this plus this plus this plus this. If you are computing all of the error, then we found a plus minus, so it means they are representing the plus minus. The average is the mean value or average is zero. Now let's talk about, previously we talk about the what is the stationary model time series. Then we talk about what are the component time series. Then we discuss about as the stationary model. Stationary model are those model. Then we draw a graph. It shows the stationary line. Some constant the simple property is the stationary model does not contain any trend, any cycle, or any seasonal component. Now within the category of the stationary model, we have the subcategories as the last period method. What is the last period method? The forecast for the next period is the last observed value. F represents the forecast. Okay. Then T plus 1 means time period plus 1, and Y represents the observed value at time T. So let's give example. Right now we are in 2011. 2021. Right now we are in the most likely, for example, right now we are in the month of February. So what is the observed value do we have in the month of February? Let me give it up. 2000 is the 2000 the sales or demand for the month of February. What is the next month? Next month is the March 2021. The forecast for the March should be the same for the observed value in the month of February. It means for this data, I have the data for the month of February at time t. Observed data means observed data at time t, which is right now for the February. F forecast for the t plus 1 means March, one adding March. The forecast it should be the same. This is known as the last period method. Then example is, if the May sale worth 50, then the sale for the month of May 2020. Right now, the practical example I just mentioned about the, if the sale for the month of February are 50, then the sale for the March will also be 50. This is known the sometime cause effect, although it does not make any sense that whatever the sale of February should be the same for the next, should be the forecast for the, it should be the same for the next. It does not make any sense. At least it gives us a starting point. Sometimes cause effective and efficient, at least it provides a starting point which more sophisticated model than a photo can be. It means that at least they provide a starting point. Then, in other words, we can say later on we will discuss some more very good sophisticated method, and those methods required some starting point, and this last period method provide a mechanism. Now let's talk about the another more moving average method or the weighted moving average method. In the area of stationary, the forecast is the average of the last n observation of the time series. So in time series, we can say suppose yt is the observed value at time t, yt minus 1 observed value at time t1, so unless tn minus 1, then what I will do, example, I will start with example. Suppose right now we are dealing with a 2021 starting, it is a starting one, 2021. It means if I have some value for 2020, 2019, 2018, etc., then I will divide by total number of years for the observation, divide by n. For example, make the average of 5 years. Then how can you forecast? Make a summation of all of them, divide by n, then it will be the forecast for the next, forecast for the 2021. Now another category for the weighted moving average method. The most recent value of the time series get the larger weightage than the past value when performing the forecast. In this type of the forecasting technique, the most recent one should have the more weightage. For example, let me give the a little bit, I will change a little bit. Suppose I want to make the forecast for the March 2021, then what I require the past data for the January, past data for the February, then past data for the January, then the past data for the December 2020, for the November 2020. Here what they mentioned that the most recent one should have the more weightage. So what's the most recent one to making the forecast for the March? The most recent is the data for the February, so it must have the more weightage. Then how do we compute forecast for t plus 1, for time t plus 1, equal to weightage w1 multiplied by the observed value at time t, then t minus 1, t minus 2 observed, with these are the observed value for t minus 1, t minus 2. Here we have the, it must multiply by corresponding weightage 1, weightage 2, weightage 3, weightage n minus weightage n, for example weightage n. Moreover, as I just mentioned about the most recent have the large weightage. Most, it means W1, which is the most recent one, because it represents this W1 represented by the, it multiplied by the most recent one. W1 is the more weightage, W2, etc. Moreover, sum of all of the weightage should be equal to 1. Inshallah, this will be more clear when I will try to explain this concept with the model, then it will be more clear. Now let's talk about the moving average method. Yes, as the forecast for the future time period. It means right now I can make for the monthly forecast, I can make the forecast for the March, because right now we are dealing with the February 2021. Using the technique that we can forecast for the next, that is for the month of March 2001. What about if you want to make the forecast monthly, or the April, May, June, July, June, July for the 2021? It means these are the forecasts for the future time period. The forecast for the time period t plus 1 is the focus of all of the future type. It means all of the future. It means whatever I will make the forecast for the month of March 2021, it will be the same for the April, May, June, July, for rest, all of the rest of the forecasting. So in other words, we can say it represents forecast for T plus K. It will be the same for the, it will be the same for the YT. Or as you can see, let me show you. In this equation, for example, this forecast for T plus 1 is equal to observed value. So here they mention about the all of the future value. So the forecast is, then in other words, we can say the forecast will revise only when we have the new data is available. Now let's talk about the, okay, this require a little bit of time will be required in this example. In this so okay, we will continue this example in the next lecture. One more thing about yesterday, day before yesterday, I have sent an email to you that we want to reschedule our midterm exam. Previously it was scheduled on Thursday, on Thursday 11th of March, but there is a conflict. One of the students, because of the conflict, obviously we need to make the reschedule exam. The student is contacted with you and he get the, he has the pooling. In the pooling, all of the students, they agree. Moreover, I also send you day before yesterday an email that if any of you have any conflict and concern for the new proposed date, that is on the Wednesday 10th of March, let me know. I did not receive a single complaint, single conflict. So it means today, inshallah, right now, I am forwarding this new date to the examination committee. So this is the last week, can say. I will forward to the examination committee. So I think I did not receive any of the complaint, any of the concern for the new rescheduling exam. One more thing about this, one thing, the month all of on next Tuesday you will have the quiz, online quiz number 2. This will be during the lecture timing, that is from 9 to 10. It will not be anymore at 5 o'clock. So during the, I have already uploaded the LMS now. So thanks of you, thank you very much. You may leave the session.